Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Q&A with P&J. I'm John.
And I'm Pedro. Now let's dive into some questions we've received from the community. John, why don't you kick it off?
Sure thing. All right, the first question that we have this week is, do you have maintenance windows? And if so, how often?
So thanks to the fact that we do rolling upgrades during our normal updates, you know, we don't experience any kind of downtime. During major updates or infrastructure changes, there may be a small maintenance window, but those are always communicated with you ahead of time. And it's very brief and it won't take down your project. It will only impact your ability to log in for a brief time.
All right, let's move on to the next question, Pedro.
All right. Does Directus use server-side state management or stateless for custom extensions?
Great question. There's no built-in state management, so it is stateless by default. That being said, your custom extensions do have access to the database, so that's a great place to store stateful information.
Awesome.
That's a good question.
Cool.
On to the next. So I guess that'll be me.
Yes.
One of our users on GitHub, J-A-A-D-S, I'm going to call you Jad because that's kind of rad.
Jad's rad.
I see 7 languages enabled in my Directus right now. Is there a way to add more languages?
Yeah, so currently we support 58 languages, but we can add any language via Crowdin. So the full list can be found at the link on the screen. And as you can see in this video, it's very easy to add to your environment.
Awesome. Hey everyone, John here with a quick interruption. When we record these things originally, we don't have a script, so sometimes we have to come back with a little bit of a clarification, but I wanted to be clear around translations. There's the app translations, and that's when we were discussing 58 languages used via Crowdin. That's one way that the app handles translations, but then there's also the translations of the content. So that also, you can add any number of translations to that as well, but I wanted to make sure what we were discussing was the app being translated itself, and then what we were showing in the video was actually translating the content. So just a quick little clarification there. We'll get right back to the video. Thanks. All right, Pedro, what is the next question?
All right, so the next question. A member of our GitHub community asks, is there a way to currently get real-time subscription updates in Directus, whether it's via the JavaScript SDK or GraphQL? And if there isn't, are there any other external tools I can use?
Well, our CTO Reich himself answered this in GitHub, but the answer is not currently, not to get those real-time subscriptions, but we do have WebSockets launching very soon. You will be able to get those real-time subscriptions. As you can see here, one of our engineers, BrainSlug, has actually been testing it out internally. Here's a really cool small feature, a chat feature that he's been testing around, but you can see here the live real-time subscriptions in action. So very exciting features coming soon.
Awesome.
All right, that's it for this week. Thanks so much for watching, and don't forget to hop into one of our communities like Discord or GitHub, or leave a comment here in YouTube. Again, we'll be taking questions from these comments to answer in further episodes. Thanks again. Have a great day.